this turbo, and they've looked absolutely incredible on it. Will this composition be enough to delete the deleters?
Yeah, you can definitely make that 81.1% from me, because XRB to the moon have been looking fantastic. Obviously, fresh off of their victory of Reformed on the jungle cleave, and now deleters, another team that they could definitely take down in this one.
I'm curious to see if the deleters are going to play this aggressively or defensively. We saw XRB to the moon dismantle jungles 2 days ago, and all the jungles were playing aggressively, so let's see how they decide to play this out. Looks like they wanted to gun down Looney, and I was actually curious if they were going to try a train the healer strategy. This can be quite effective against restoration druids in particular. Obviously, the deleters may have watched the series, I would assume they did, with XRB to the moon yesterday, and saw that going after the warrior and the shaman just wasn't working for the jungle cleave, so instead they're going to try a new target and pressure Looney.
Yeah, but Looney, definitely one of the hardest restoration druids you will ever fight as a jungle cleave. He's going to be so phenomenal. You can see him kiting around. He might even be playing the freedom on his effervescence, or that mushroom that's on the ground, to basically make it so that every time he's slowed down, he'll be able to, every time that ticks, it basically removes all slows from Looney, enabling him to run around the pillar. And I really like this kiting path from him. Since he's playing with the double melees, they're not going to have any difficulty connecting to their targets, and it makes it really hard for Lily on the Discipline Priest to heal the two melees chasing Looney, because, you know, he has to run all the way around the pillar whilst avoiding that cleave damage, which we saw yesterday from XRB is very scary.
What's interesting is the deleters are kind of not getting pressured at all by XRB to the moon. They're really just protecting Looney. We saw yesterday XRB to the moon kind of found out that attacking the priest was the best target, winning the game in a matter of seconds as soon as they swapped to him. But because they're pressuring Looney, XRB to the moon are playing a lot more conservative and just trying to protect the tree and keep him alive as long as possible. But I'm not sure that's their best strategy. They may just win a healer race, and they may end up just wasting their time going onto the DPS in this specific matchup. Looney trading out through basically a large amount of his defensive arsenal. He's going to start to fall behind. The deleters have been getting excellent crowd control on Z-Pi with the Psychic Screams and the Diamond Ice traps. With Diamond Ice being undispellable, Looney is not able to get support from Z-Pi for that time. Finally, XRB to the moon, they feel comfortable. They survived the incarnation. They wanted to play conservative until that cooldown was out of the way. Now that the threat is gone, it's time to gun down Lily.
Yeah, and it's been working so well for them. They trade out incarnation for incarnation on XRB, and Lily's also dropping low on mana, so the strategy's definitely working for XRB to the moon right now. A lot of that, of course, will come down to Looney, but also you have to talk about the enhancement off healing. Very, very significant in these games. Now the damage starting to overwhelm the leaders as big mechs forced into the aspect of the turtle. This is where XRB will start to win the game. They're tunneling down Lily, the Rapture, the last real defensive cooldown here for the leaders, who will surely fall very shortly in this game, Sid.
Nice play there from Blizzo. He had damage on Lily, but instead chose to fear him and then stun him and switch targets and really put the priest far behind. He's almost completely tapped on mana. His entire team is running out of cooldowns. We're not even into dampening. I don't see any openings for them right now. XRB the Moon are looking unbreakable in this position. They should be likely walking away with game number one. This strategy adaptation by the deleters, XRB to the Moon were more than prepared for. They all in on Looney. They dealt with it perfectly. Then they survived the incarn. Then they turned it around and started going after Lily. XRB to the Moon look like they've got every strategy nailed down pat. Unless the deleters can pull off a miracle bite, I don't see any other opportunity here. Lily doing whatever he can, but with Blizzo and Z-Pi all over him, he doesn't have much time left.
He really doesn't. They need about 40 seconds for that incarnation on Big Peter, but I think it's very unlikely that they're going to make it that far. Looney trinkets out. He knows his team is very close to the win here, as Lily will drop into XQ range. Blizzo will be doing increased damage there. Pennants, windshield, Shadowman should be interrupted as well. Here comes the kill. Surely executes will connect. Looney also dropping low though. He's caught up in a bit of trouble. Rallying Cry comes out. He's line of sighting. Big Peter running for his life as Lily and Big Max fall. This should be game one in favor of XRB to the moon.
And XRB is going to be able to take that first game.
Take cooldowns on himself. It's very easy to do that as a druid. They need to split some damage on Blizzo and Looney. That way when Looney runs a vertical angle around the pillar away from the team, you switch back to Blizzo. You start attacking him. Looney has to come back to you to heal him, and you keep pressure on two targets. You make it more difficult to manage your cooldowns, and you can catch the rest of Druid off guard. But it looks like they're going to completely play a different strategy, gunning down Z-Pi instead this match. They didn't like the all-in, so they're going to be going back to the more standardized strategy. Oh, no, they are mixing it up, and this is exactly what the deleters need to do. Just attack multiple targets, try to create multiple openings, and put Looney on the back foot.
Yep, Looney caught up in the tree there. Actually, the trap broke work, unfortunately, but I really like the strategy to your point, Sid. They open up on Zpi, they should get the dots on Looney, and then when they force him to low health, they can trap him up, and then when Looney gets out of that trap, which inevitably he will, he has basically two jobs to do rather than one, right? Like, he needs to keep Zpi alive, but he also needs to stabilize himself before the next stun DR, when they would then swap over to Looney once again. So I think this is potentially even the best strategy from the leaders. The other benefit, of course, is mana. Restoration Druids, when they're healing multiple targets, do struggle a little bit with that mana pool. And in the early game, the leaders have the lead.
Ooh, nice play by Blizzo, breaking that crowd control chain up by stacking on Looney and eating a freezing trap. That could have been devastating for the team of XRB to the moon, but we talked about him in the pregame. Blizzo MVP defense, going for that Blade Storm, trying to chop up the team. Looney getting pressured. I love this split targeting. The only thing I think that could be better is if they're going on Blizzo and Looney and crowd controlling Zpi, because his off-healing is going to allow Looney to kind of breathe easy, whereas Blizzo doesn't have that same utility. We're going to have to wait and see how it plays out. Looney starting to fall a bit behind. Mana is much more in favor of the deleters regardless with this strategy change. And I'm happy to see that this newcomer team, the underdogs out of nowhere, they're able to step up their play even mid-tournament.
Yeah, I mean, they're looking fantastic in this game. And if they can keep landing the crowd controls onto Looney while having this pressure, it's going to put him very, very far behind. But Big Mex is struggling a little bit with that task right now. One of the things you should bear in mind for the Discipline Priest, Psychic Scream, the Fear, is on a 30-second cooldown, whereas Zpi's Tremor's on a 1-minute cooldown, so he's not going to have it every time. We see Full Trap to follow up the Fear there on Looney, forcing a bit of pressure over onto Zpi, but Looney now not under too much pressure. They need to swap back over onto him if they are to keep this up.
And XRB to the Moon at the same time, they're trying to protect their tree, but they also want to be attacking the Priest. He's the easiest and squishiest target to attack. It's risky because you leave your Druid, you can't protect him to go after that, and XRB to the Moon are trying to find the best moment to do it. And right now, the deleters have really kept them on the back foot. They've kept them in an awkward position. Mana's completely tied. I like this pressure on Blizzo. Now they're actually going after all three targets, really trying to expend Looney's mana bar, switching to Looney out of the freezing trap. These are great swaps by the deleters. Perfect setup. It's really throwing Looney for a loop, but if there was a Resto Druid that could handle this kind of pressure, it would be him. Let's see if the deleters can really take him out. Triple stun from Zpi. Perfect timing. Amazing swap to Lylee. Purging off those Power Word shields instantly, putting him incredibly far on the back foot. He had to expend a lot of mana to recover through that. XRB to the Moon finally getting that moment to swap to the Priest, punishing that stacked up overcommitment by them. Perfect timing.
Yeah, perfect timing. And then Zpi also gets the grounding on the full freezing trap there. That's going to enable XRB to the Moon to be incredibly aggressive here. They forced all the defensives on Lylee using the Fear here. Looney just able to easily dispel that. No crowd cross crowd control over onto him. This healer race will definitely go in favor of XRB to the Moon. They need to find a way, the leaders, of getting the trap over onto Looney. There's catch him out of form in the bash. Bit of trouble. Preemptively iron barking, though. Should be able to stabilize with the off heals from Zpi. I'd love to see them trap him up right now and swap some damage over onto Blizzo or Zpi. Looks like that might be the play, might be the move coming out of Big Mex right here, but he's looking to keep the mana pressure on Looney. They're not going to win this race. Ascendance from Zpi. Blizzo in the Blade Storm looking for the kill. They get the pommel, looking for the execution. This could be game, Sid. And XRB to the Moon going 2-0 up, but I really like the adaptation from the leaders.
I think the leaders had a fantastic adaptation. The opening now, let's see if XRB can get it done.
Well, this map is where the legendary Feral Druid Ashimane fell, and likely now could be Big Peter following him shortly. They may have to build a monument in his name, because if they don't clean up their play here and pick some better targets, really, because attacking Zpi and Looney, Zpi can easily heal to the pressure. If they crowd control him instead and go after Blizzo and Looney, they don't get that type of utility. And so far, they're not committing to that strategy, instead focusing what seems to be more on Zpi, but slightly mixing up and going after Looney. They've got the right idea, switching between multiple targets. I just think they need to switch between the Warrior and the Druid, not the Shaman and the Druid. And if they can execute that properly, I think they can come out ahead.
Yeah, we can see tree form exchange for the Incarnation from Big Peter once again. Good plays from Looney. And this is the thing about XRB to the Moon. They're so good at these defensive playstyles. Like, you can try catch Looney off guard, and whereas most Druids probably would falter against such a devastating jungle cleave, XRB have played so many games. Looney and Zpi are BFA BFFs. They play together all the time. They're so solid when they are doing so. And Looney just always has the answer. The Incarnation matched Iron Bark preemptively at the start. We see a full trap here, but Zpi will have the off healing to go through it. They're getting pressure over onto So Lily and XRB are just sitting pretty in this game.
Yeah, now they're able to chase down the Discipline Priest. There's not enough pressure on Looney, and this is going to put the Deleters heavily behind. It's going to expend a lot more mana than typically otherwise. This game is looking much worse for them than the Tolvaron Arena game. How much longer can Lily keep this up? They're just sitting right on top of them. These Shadowmans are big heals, but they're expensive ones. Triple Fear from Blizzo, allowing Looney some breathing room. Reverse Triple from Lily. There was actually an opportunity there to try and take Looney out. He's got no Bark Skins, actually. If they can just stay on target and crowd control Zipai in this position, Looney could be in trouble.
Yeah, he really could, but I don't think they're running the Diamond Ice talent, which would obviously be beneficial if they were going to commit a little bit more to this strategy, making the traps underspellable over onto Zipai. Meanwhile, Lily's mana is not a pretty tale. 20% on that blue bar. Health also not looking fantastic as we see a trap onto Blizzo easily dispelled by Looney as Deleters are falling further and further behind.
I mean, at this point, it's match point. He's got almost zero mana. All of his cooldowns have been burned down. Power Shield is all he can press, but Zipai can remove that. He can't cast Shadow Mends. He's got no mana. He's just on the ropes at this point. His XRB to the moon assert almost complete dominance. Lily is just flailing to stay alive in this barrier, but this Bladestorm is shredding. Deleters, they spread out to try and avoid the damage, but even with that, Lily is just getting crushed under the weight of XRB to the moon as they advance to the grand finals. Can these jungles figure out a strategy as they showdown to decide who is the king of the jungle in the lower bracket?
Feed versus the fake Zebras, we're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.